I'm just going to demonstrate painting black lining on a little owl. For this, I generally have a wet rag because since it's a 360-degree figure, you're going to roll it over your hands. You're going to get some black overlays on your hands, which you don't want to keep transferring. So as I'm working, I tend to just keep my hands clean. I could also use a metal wheel here, a banding wheel, but I like handling better. My hands are so small, and it's just easier to control. So I got that. I got several different brushes. I have a slightly diluted little cup of Amaco black underglaze here, and some water to wash my brushes. So the first thing I do is just decide what kind of personality these guys have. This guy's kind of leaning to one side, so probably I'm going to do wide open, curious eyes, but owls are very, very curious, so I like to do the curious ones a lot, but they also have lots of other expressions. They're very expressive creatures. You know, anything that can turn its head all the way around and look at you, that's got to be a character. Now, the nice thing about porcelain is that the particular porcelain I use shrinks about 12%. So it can be a little messy. And the final firing of the glaze will kind of correct for you, which is sort of sweet. It tends to look nice even if the original painting is not absolutely perfect. Though, you know, I do strive to do a good job on these. And, you know, they do require a nice touch, but, you know, I try not to obsess over each little stroke. I try to just let it flow and go around the figure and get all the details in here. The wings, tails. This is probably going to be a solid figure. I might go into more detail if I was doing a more natural colored one, but I'm going to probably glaze this in a turquoise or a bright orange or red. So he doesn't need lots of details. It's going to be solid and shiny and colorful. So, there he goes. And you can see there's already a little army building up. And then this one looks kind of angry. Got brows. And plus it's, you know, modeled after Great Horned Owl, which are kind of legendarily grumpy creatures. I don't know if you've ever been near one that's been nesting, but they will take your scalp off. So I always think of them as being kind of grumpy. I mean, they're probably sweet, but, you know. They're probably sweet when they don't have chicks to defend. So, one angry one. And I have to be kind of careful how many expressions I have. I find that the kind of angry ones don't sell very fast, so I end up with a lot of angry owls in my inventory, if I'm not careful. So, hey, this one's a little more shifty than angry, but I don't like that. It looks like he's conspiring. So I've got a lot of up and down strike ones, so let's do this sideways. Also, there's this odd little axiom that goes with owls that horned ones sell better than the plain-headed ones. I don't know why that is, but people seem to like horned owls the most. Of course, I like the ones that are smooth-headed the most. I think they look like little people, so I tend to make more smooth ones than horned owls. But yeah, these are still cute, like little horns. And of course, you don't have to circle and make a dot. I mean, you get a dot. So, a simple, small eyeball is enough. You can actually have a lot of personality just with very little work at all.